Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Wyrmstooth. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today we'll be reading Wyrmstone, Red and Blue, which I found right here in Fort Moonwatch. Wyrmstone, Red and Blue, report by Lurius Lior. Wyrmstooth's value to the Empire in terms of its natural resources is certainly undeniable, though perhaps at times unappreciated. While ebony may be a scarce commodity on the island, Wyrmstooth is host to a unique ore rarely seen elsewhere on mainland Tamriel, which has hence earned the name Wyrmstone. The bluish ore is distributed fairly ubiquitously across the island, and trace amounts seem to permeate practically all rock. As to the nature of the ore itself, studies indicate structural properties similar to those seen in malachite and other naturally occurring glass. Some scholars indicate that it is in fact a form of malachite exposed to unusual geological conditions. However, this is still subject to further inquiry. Recent analysis from the College of Winterhold indicates that each fragment of the material holds a very subtle magical charge. Blacksmiths, however, report the fragile nature of the ore as being very difficult or impractical to work with. Of course, this does not mean that it is impossible, and the practical implementation of the material may not necessarily be limited to the crafting of weapons and armor. On my most recent voyage to the Imperial City, I was granted a brief opportunity to speak with the Moth Priests and question them about the unusual nature of the ore. Some claim the Dwemer knew of a way to refine it into a material they call Aetherium, though this seems to be a matter of contention, as the Dwemer were said to have refined Aetherium from meteoric glass, not volcanic glass. Regardless, the magical nature of the ore draws a number of mages to the island on an annual basis. What they do with the ore they dig up, and the quantity they remove from the island, is beyond the interest of the East Empire Company given its current lack of mainstream value. However, some enchanters are known to use the material in the creation of staffs. A rare variant of Wyrmstone is sporadically encountered following recent seismic activity. Brimstone, reddish in color, has proven to be even more brittle than standard Wyrmstone. Given time, Brimstone eventually transforms to the common blue Wyrmstone as seen elsewhere around the island. The cause behind this transformation is likely chemical in nature, perhaps a reaction caused by extended exposure to the atmosphere or a reaction with sunlight. Further analysis will determine the structural differences between the two ores once a sample becomes available. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Wyrmstooth, Wyrmstone, Red and Blue.